Howdy, hi. How are we today? I hope you're doing very well. Welcome back to TerraFirmaPunk. This is episode number 4, I believe. I've been cooking myself up some pots, but one of these pots is special because it has a little bit of copper in it. Reason being, my pick is about to die, and before I do anything else, I'm just going to make me a little temporary copper one, because I'm going to be doing a little bit of building around the place, as promised. So, I wanted to talk you through some of the plans for the episode. Obviously, last time I was aiming for the anvils, and the Bloomery was a kind of a stretch target, if you like. But I ended up gathering so much various metals and minerals that I didn't get to making anything. I just explored the world and died a lot. So, I've gathered in this chest the materials I need on this top row for my copper anvil. If I've done my maths right, if I haven't, I'm sure you will notice. But that's the copper anvil there, the top row. This second row is the bronze anvil. And then this third row here is for the Bloomery. It is a shame, looking at these different types of bronze, it's a shame that I'm having to go for the sort of standard bronze, because the black bronze and the bismuth bronze are slightly more efficient in that they use less copper. But then again, I'm not sure how useful copper is after you get past this stage anyway, because once we have the Bloomery, that's what we use to make iron, and then I wonder how useful the copper is anyway, and we still have... Okay, so we still have a full barrel and a bit left anyway to just make pretty ingots to stack in our vault. So I'm going to be doing that. I'll be doing a lot of metalworking in just a second, and that's why I cooked up all of these pots as well, because there's a cheeky trick we can do to make our anvils without having to make our forges. Nevertheless, I'm going to also work on the workshop, this building here that we've got a base for, a bit today. As I mentioned, I want a vault. That's going to go underground. I'm going to start digging out down here and make a sort of basement, if you like, where we'll store all our metals. I think, probably, that'd be cool. Here is the piece of smooth stone. That anvil I just picked up is a vanilla anvil. I don't think I can do anything with it, but I just thought it would look cool here. But this is going to be our stone anvil. Have I got a hammer? I don't. But anyway, we'll turn that into a stone anvil in a sec. And I'm going to need to build a forge. But I'm going to be making my anvils before I kind of finalize this. But I thought the forge might look nice out of this basalt. But I only got 10 pieces, and I wanted, hopefully, to make a triple forge. I don't know if that's really extravagant. I think it would be nice to have a triple, because I know when we get to later stages with the what do you call the thing that you blow smoke onto the forge with, the bellows, when we make bellows, then we're gonna want probably multiple forges, and the crucible as well, I think, sits on top of a forge. This doesn't give too much away, but I've never actually got to the stage of making a crucible in TerraFirmaCraft before. So we will be getting towards uncharted territory there. But I was thinking maybe it would go here. I don't know, could we do something like this? How many of these have we got? I'm like one short just to do the front. Well, we'll think about it. Anyway, we're going to do something like that. I'm not entirely sure. But for now, I'm going to start cooking up this here, and we'll go with our copper anvil to get us going for the episode. So I'm going to cook all this up. I think I can just do it like this, although I might want to be a little bit more strategic. What would I do? Something like that. So it's evenly spread across two vessels. And what we're basically going to do is pour the liquid copper out of these vessels. And as it's liquid in its ingot cast, it's going to cool. But before it cools all the way down, we'll use the heat from the initial cooking that we did to weld the ingots together to make the double ingots. which means we don't need to use the forge to heat them. That might sound confusing, but I'll show you in a second. But right now it's nighttime, so what we're going to do as well is make ourselves our bed. Because I gathered the second round of jute from there. Ooh. I'm going to steal that, because I don't want a massive sequoia tree growing out of my fruit tree garden. So, what we're going to do is use all this jute fibre. I've now got a whole stack of it to make ourselves a bed. And so use a loom like this. And then do you weave it? It's got a cool animation, I believe. There we go. Shift right click. And look, it's so cool. I love these touches in TerraFirmaCraft. You can literally see it being weaved through. That's a nice touch. And then it pops off. And there we go. We've got ourselves a piece of cloth. So I'm going to do that twice more now. And I will not subject you to it. Pop. There we go. Three pieces. So now, what do we need? Some wood. Three pieces. Amazing. And it's very similar to the vanilla recipe. There it is, a real bed. Oh, I can't tell you how happy I am that we have this. But I'm not going to actually keep it in here. I will just put it here for now, so we can pass the night. But I think I'm going to live in the workshop, you know? I mean, like, I'll probably build a house, like, eventually. Oh yeah, like, you get real hungry when you sleep because all that time's passed. I'm, like, real hungry and thirsty. Yeah, food. I guess I don't need to carry this jute around with me anymore. Where's my kind of nature chest here? You can go in there too. Do I have somewhere for string? I would have thought it would have been in there. Oh no, I remember I had set up a loom out here, didn't I? Back when I didn't think I was going to make it to all of that jute. Yeah, so we're gonna live in the workshop. just out of convenience, I think, more than anything. Oh, I'm real thirsty, I can't move. Die, Matt. Yeah, because, like, you know, we're gonna be doing most of our work in this workshop, right? Now, this is the other thing, I need to be careful about when I cook that stuff. So we're just gonna live up here. For now, do I want to leave it there though until I've built this place up a bit more? No, we'll just whack it down. I'm sure it'll be fine. So we're gonna cook these up, right? So I need some thatch, which I do have plenty of. Where are my torches at? It's gone awfully dark in here. That's better. I guess I need four pieces like that. Is that going to be 16? Yes, it is. And I did chop down one sequoia tree last episode. You'll notice I've got a lot of wood stockpiled here. I just did it for convenience, really. It's a bit of a shame because sequoia wood's quite hard to come by, to be using it for sort of like fuel. But I'm real lazy. Oh, for some reason I thought I was doing two. I'm just doing one. But do I want to do this right now? I don't think the answer is yes, because I really need to pounce on it as soon as they come out so they're fresh, because I need maximum time to kind of do this cooling trick that I'm going to do. So I'm going to time it with the sun. I believe one of these takes 8 hours. The other thing is, they take 8 in-game hours, I think. But the other thing is, I don't have any ingot casts. I need a load of ingot casts, and that's why I needed to do two. See, there was method to my madness. I think 6 ingot casts should be enough. But should we just go to town and do 10? Let's just go to town and do 10. Which means I'm going to need more thatch. So I'm going to set all this up anyway. And we need to dismantle that. So it's these two. Yep. And then we're going to have all of these in all the gaps. Another one here. Poor me, no shovel. Okay, good. And I'll time setting these off with the night so that then I can get in, I'll light them all, get in the bed, it'll be morning, and then they'll, if it all goes to plan, I'll wake up just as they've finished so I can grab the copper while it's at its hottest and get to work. And I'm going to also need to obviously turn this into a proper anvil. So we'll do all that and we'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. I am somewhat scared, but so far the spawns seem to be in my favour. They have the those two there have the ingot casts in, and I think as soon as we hit, maybe I'll just do it now. I was waiting for hour 22, which I think will work, assuming we wake up at 6, hour 6, and these take 8 hours. Okay, let's see if we're in business. Wish me luck. Might have been a waste of time, but see, now they're all done, which is excellent. And hopefully, this has not been done for very long, so these will still be liquid for quite some time. Yeah, 700 units each. This seems right. So we've got our anvil set up here. I've put straw in there so that I can quickly transfer items. And now we're gonna take it away. So we chuck an ingot cast in. And I'll just show you maybe part of this process and then cut away if it kind of is ends up taking too long, but you'll get the idea. So we have two there. They're both kind of poured at roughly the same time, right? I'm going to leave a little gap because we don't want to get ahead of ourselves with this either. Have a little munch. I'm going to do two more. The important thing here is about managing your inventory so you don't get confused. So I'm going to see there, these are now turning white. They're not brilliant white anymore, but these are still brilliant white. So they're like a pair. They're a pair. Have another little munch. Maybe we'll do the next pair now. And you've got to move quick enough here. Without kind of overstretching yourself. If we go too quick in this first stage, we won't be able to keep up with them later when we're trying to pull off all the other stages piece by piece. See, they're liquid still. Okay, so as soon as they turn solid, we need to take them out, chuck them in here and weld them before they become too cold to weld. Because they'll be solid, but they'll still be incredibly hot. So that's the theory here. I just think it's fun. It's kind of interesting way of doing this. And we're going to obviously be recycling these molds. So there we go. We've got another pair there. They're still liquid. I thought I made 10, did I? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, I did. I just can't count. So they're still liquid. We'll do two more. And then, oh, look, they've just changed. This was potentially a mistake doing these. But let's do it anyway. If we've missed these, then so be it. We shouldn't have. See, and there, having those there means I can shift click them in and they go straight into the welding slots. So there we go, we welded it, we've got it, we've got our double ingot. And these are going solid now. That one's still liquid. There we go. Bang, number two. But we've got to keep going, so I'm going to pour two more now. And you see these are now still liquid. So yeah, we're looking good for this. But you get the idea, right? It's a pretty nifty trick, I like it. Okay, we can do these now. That one's still liquid. There we go. Brutal. The efficiency. Not always the most efficient, but you know, I like to pull it out of the bag every now and again. we'll just put this last set there, I'll just remember. Or maybe we'll put them below, then it was kind of logical. Right, everything's poured, and I'm just going to go through that process with these. So as they turn solid, bang, waiting for this one still. Yes, and I will see you when I've got all seven. And bang, there it is. Look at that. So, because they're all varying heats, that's why they don't stack. So I have to do this laborious task of individually placing them all. But there we go. There's our copper anvil. Awesome. They're small, aren't they? But, yeah, nice. They look good. So we'll take all of this out of there. We don't even need to keep that anymore. That's just like a useless piece of stone now, I suppose. Chuck these in, and literally, I can just do the exact same thing with the bronze. And I think it is the quickest way. How are we doing for time today? Yes, I'm going to do the same thing. My timings seem to work perfectly. Wait till hour 21, and then cook it. Still got the 10, so I only need to do one... what do you call it? One pit kiln. And it's exactly the same amount of metal, except for 6 of the pieces of cassiterite instead to make up 10%. To make our bronze recipe. You see here, there's the recipe, right? Between, sort of, it's roughly 10% you need. So, yeah, I'm going to do the same thing. And I'll be right back. Alright. Oh, mate, the bronze solidified. I think they have different cooling, like, and solidifying temperatures and stuff, so what worked with the copper, timings-wise, didn't work so well with the bronze. I only managed to get 4 of them done, so I'm just cooking up the rest, but I should have it done by the end of the day, I think. Oh no. 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 This is not good. Okay. Go. Where's the last one? Where did it go? There it is. This is unbelievable. Come on, please don't have cooled. Please. Yes! Alright, sleep. Oh, the panic. We did it. Okay, good. And look, in the meanwhile, during the day, I think I've come up with something I like for my triple forge. That only uses 10 of the basalt blocks that I picked up from a ruin. I mean, I could go and find another ruin, or I could find another biome that has more basalt, but I kind of like that. I might take out these floor blocks around it to kind of give it a trim. I don't know, we'll see. But, I mean, that depends as I build the rest of the building up. We're going to want a chimney for it as well. But I think I like that. That's kind of like foundation. And at any rate, like, you know, the building doesn't have walls right now. We can now start to use these, which I think, you know, we may want to do when making this bloomery piece, because the scale of it is just insane. So to make this anvil, which we can make now, we used 14 ingots pressed into double ingots, so 7 double ingots gets us our bronze anvil. Pow. Looking good. So that's, yeah, 14 ingots, right? Using the cooling method, or whatever you want to call it. Pit kiln cooling method. The dank pit kiln cooling... the dank pit kiln cooling method. But look at this. This is... What did I work it out to be? It's 32 ingots. And you press those into 16 double ingots, and then make them into sheets, and then press them into 8 double sheets to get the bloomery block. This is one expensive block. This is one block that uses up all of this, all these resources here, and I've maximized the amount of cassiterite I can use in the recipe to kind of keep my copper, because I by comparison, I have huge amounts of cassiterite, given it's not so useful. But we do have loads more of the copper around, so we, you know, it's fine. But I just think, anyway, my point that I'm rambling towards is that using the cooling method on the Bloomery block is just not going to be practical, because it got tricky even doing this anvil, to be honest, with the cooling method. So yes, I think we'll get the forges going to make the Bloomery block, which is probably what I'll do right now. No, I've changed my mind immediately. I'm going to build some walls. I'm going to start to build up this building first, before we move on to the Bloomery block. So maybe a bit of a montage is appropriate. So yes, building montage. Oh, well, before we go for this montage, I also picked up one more zombie head, which I've been waiting for, because it finishes the barn. Whoop. Perfect. Right. Where was I? Ah, yes. Building montage. Go! Okay, and we are looking pretty good, huh? I hope you enjoyed the montage there. I've done a fair amount. My inventory's in chaos, as it often is when you finish building in TFC or P or whatever you prefer. I need some water. But I think, you know, we're looking nice. There's definitely some stuff that needs ironing out. Drink. Okay. I want to get more of these smooth chalk blocks, and then they'd be there and there, sort of like mirror this, like the pattern I've laid out along the floor here, all the way around. That would just break that up a bit, and we'd probably put some windows in as well as we go along and build upwards with the walls as well. But it's, you know, it's mob proof now. Possibly spiders could climb in if they're really determined. I want to just chuck some doors on. It would be the last thing to do. Should we go for these? They're kind of a weird colour, these planks. But I think they might, in a weird way, they might suit. Let's have a look. I think ultimately we'll go with iron doors, which will look absolutely the part. And I know there's lots of stuff I'm not doing here as well, like carpenter's blocks and things I'd want to add. Yeah, that's quite nice, the green, you know. Yeah, we're good. And here's the Bloomery. So this is where we just put the Bloomery block in the front there. I moved the basalt out and put it around there. I thought it looked better, and just leave the two in the middle there to kind of make a row there. And yeah, I like it. Ooh, let's not let that despawn. I like it. Anyway, so we're going to smelt up a huge amount of bronze, as previously discussed, and make the bloomery, and then I think we'll call it an episode, because I've spent a fair bit of time on this already, and I know that getting all of this bronze together is going to be a grind. So, there it is. Gonna start piling it into these vessels and smelt it up. Okay, I just wanted to quickly show you something. I've had to rethink my ratios a little bit here to actually get it into the four vessels and still have each vessel give me bronze. Because my total had the right ratio, but it wasn't divisible by four. So I had to use a little bit more copper, a little bit less cassiterite. But those are my ratios. So I'm going to be getting 800 units out of each. And I'm hoping I'm going to be able to do that. I should be able to. And I'm just going to sort of stagger them slightly in four pit kilns. And I'm going to use the standard method, the dank cooling method, to weld them quickly. And then we'll have to start using the forges to probably heat up those double ingots to make the sheets. That's my plan. So here goes. Last set for this first batch. And bang. And just as we do that, that's at 0 hours. That's perfect. That's just finished. That timing of that was incredible. Okay, great. And we're going to do it again. And last ones. Bang. Second set of four, done. And another four. Bang. And we are done. Look at that. Let's just go for this one. See if I can just do it. So you go bang. Sweet. Okay, so I got myself one sheet. And so that's what I need to do for all 16 of these. And then weld them all together. And I'll have eight. So one thing I didn't know is that with lumber and a hammer, you can make sticks, which is awesome. So I'm just going to make a few because I need a fire lighter to get me going over here with my forge. Okay, I'm just about to turn the last double ingot into a sheet, and I've got the pairs of sheets now cooking to begin welding those as well. So we're nearly there. Well, in the grand scheme of things, definitely nearly there. Take these two off and bang, there we go, double sheet. I'm gonna fill those like that. Take these two off. Bang, right, we're in business. Yeah, this is going to probably go quite quickly now. Okay, we are approaching the end here. These can weld now, and those aren't far behind. And it was good I picked up all this coal in that last mad exploration episode, actually, because it's made this a lot quicker. It's a more efficient fuel. And I think it heats things faster as well. It certainly felt pretty quick, but it just means it's more to the point. It's just meant I can jump straight in to the forge without having to do the whole charcoal pit thing. Let's salvage that. And we're done. Look, there they are. 32 ingots into 8 double sheets. And here we go. This is what I said I would do at the beginning of the last episode, and there's been many, many hours since then, but there it is, the bloomery. That is the Iron Age right there. So I think it's been a good couple of episodes. We've done a lot, and I suppose next episode we'll have to go out and get some iron. There's rich limonite over that way. I think there's more back in the direction we explored. You know, that we came from, that we went last time. So there's lots of places I know there to be rich limonite. So, yes. Iron Age, here we come. Alright, thank you for watching, peeps. Take care.
Peace.